This afternoon, my obligation ceases. Individually, I love you with affection unspeakable.
Aww.
But such is my sense of duty that once out of my indentures, I shall feel my bound heart and soul to your extermination.
Poor lad!
Well, Frederick, we cannot blame you for acting on that conviction. Always act in accordance with the dictates of your conscience, my boy, and chance the consequences.
Besides, we can't offer you road sanitation to stay with us. We can't seem to make piracy pay, I'm not sure why.
But we don't. I know why. But alas, I mustn't tell you, it wouldn't be right.
Why not, my lad? It's only 11:30, and you're one of us until the clock strikes 12.
Yes. True. And until then, you're bound to protect our interests.
Yeah.
Very well, then. It is my duty as a pirate to tell you that you are too tender-hearted. For instance, you make the point of never attacking a weaker party than yourselves. And when you attack a stronger party, you invariably get threshed.
You know, there's some truth in that.
Then, again, you make a point of never molesting an orphan.
Of course, we're all orphans here. Yeah. We know what it is.
Yeah. Yes, but it has got about. And what is the consequence? Everyone we capture says they're an orphan. The last three ships we took proved to be manned entirely by orphans, so we had to let them go. Anyone would think Great Britain's mercantile navy was recruited from an orphan asylum, which we know isn't the case.
Well, thank you, George. You wouldn't have us absolutely merciless.
Well, there's my difficulty, you see. Until 12 o'clock, I would. After 12 o'clock, I wouldn't. Was ever a man placed in so delicate a situation?
And Ruth, your own Ruth, whom you love so well, and who has won her middle-aged way into your boyish heart, what is to become of her?
Oh, he will take you with him.
Well, Ruth, I feel some difficulty about you. It is true, I admire you very much. But yours is the only woman's face I've seen since joining the Pirates. And I believe it is a pretty face.
It is! Oh, it is!
I say I think it is. That is my impression. But as I have not had the opportunity of comparing you with, other women, it is quite possible I may be mistaken.
True.
What a terrible thing it would be if I were to marry this innocent person and then find out she's on the whole plain.
Oh, Ruth is very well indeed.
Yeah, there's the remains of a fine woman about our room.
Do you really think so?
I do.
Then I shall not be so selfish as to take her from you. Oh, in justice to her and in consideration for you, I will leave her behind.
No, Frederick. We are not men who lead a rough life. But we are not so utterly heartless as to deprive thee of thy love. I think I'm right in saying that there is not one here who would rob thee of this inestimable treasure, for all the world holds dear.
Not one?
Not one.
No, I thought there wasn't. Take thy love, Frederick, take thy love.
Oh, you're very good, I'm sure. There you go.
Where's the top of the tide? We must be off. Farewell, Frederick. When your process of extermination begins, let our deaths be as swift and painless as you can conveniently make them.
I will. By the love I have for you, I swear it. Would that you would render this extermination unnecessary by accompanying me back to civilization.
No, Frederick, that cannot be. I don't think much of our profession, but contrasted with respectability, it's comparatively honest. No, Frederick, I shall live and die a pirate king!
Oh, better far to live and die on the brave black flag I fly than play a sanctimonious part with a pirate's head and a pirate's heart. Away to the cheating world go you, where pirates all are well to do, but I'll be true to the song I sing, and live and die a pirate king. For I am
am a pirate king, and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king, for I am a pirate king.
You are a rocker, pirate king,
and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
It is the rocker, the pirate king, the rocker, the pirate king.
When I sadly thought to seek my plate, I helped myself in a loyal way. I shipped a few more skips, it's true, a well-bred born and what to do. But many a king on a first-class throne, if he wants to call his crown his own, must manage somehow to get through more dirty work than ever I do. For I am a pirate king, and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. For I am a pirate king.
You are the wrong of a pirate king.
And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
It is the wrong of a pirate king.
Oh, Thank you. responsibility, we are the first human beings ever to set foot in this enchanted spot.
Except for mermaids. It's the very place for mermaids.
We are only human beings down to the waist.
And can't be strictly said to have set foot anywhere. Tails they may, feet they cannot.
What shall we do until Father arrives with the luncheon?
Well, we're quite alone, and the sea is as smooth as glass. Let's take off our shoes and stockings and paddle.
Yes, 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 Dorothy!
Stop, ladies, pray! Where is he? I had intended not to intrude myself upon your notice in this effective but alarming costume. But under these peculiar circumstances, it is my bounded duty to inform you that your proceedings will not be unwitnessed.
But who are you, sir? Speak!
I am a pirate!
A pirate! Horror!
Ladies, do not shun me. This evening I renounce my vile profession. And to this end, O pure and fearless maidens, O blushing buds of ever-growing beauty, I sore at heart, implore your kind assistance.
How pitiful his tale,
how rare his beauty.
I love you.
Then I can hum a fugue of which I've heard the music's in a four. dinner for. Another rhyme. Another rhyme for dinner for.
Corridor?
No.
Matador?
Oh, far too Spanish.
Insectivore.
Insectivore? Ah. Why, Dammy, that's a lot. Dammy. I know where that one comes from.
Yes.
And whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense pinafore.
Whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense pinafore. Whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense pinafore.
Babbling on a cuneiform and tell you every detail of Caractacus's uniform. It shows in matters vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a modern major general.
It shows in matters vegetable, animal, and mineral. He is the very model of a modern major general.
In fact, when I know what is meant by mamelon and ravelin, when I can tell at sight a trident missile from a javelin, when such affairs are sorties and surprises I'm more wary at, and when I know precisely what is meant by commissariat, when I have learnt what progress has been made in modern gunnery, when I know more of tactics than a novice in a nunnery, in short, when I've a smattering of elemental strategy. Oh dear, strategy, that's a hard one.
Jamboree,
no, not very good there.
A bumblebee.
Bumblebee, that's got a skin in the tail.
What about pedigree, chum?
Why do you always have to make a dog's dinner of everything? Do you know, this man really ought to be horseman.
Wit.
Oh, yes. You'll say a better major general has never sat at
you. Say a better major general has never sat at you. Say a better major general has never sat at you. Say a better major general has never sat at you.
For my military knowledge, though unplucky and adventury, has only been brought down to the beginning of the century, but still in matters vegetable, animal, and mineral, I am the very model of a modern major general.
Say a matters vegetable, animal, and mineral, he is the very model of a modern major general.
In two words, we propose to marry your daughters.
Against our wills, father.
Oh, against our wills.
But you mustn't that. I say, this is a very picturesque uniform, but I'm not familiar with it. What are you?
We are all single gentlemen.
I rather gathered that. Anything else?
No, nothing else.
Don't believe them, father. They are pirates. Pirates of Penzance.
Pirates of Penzance? Oh, I've often heard of them.
All except this gentleman. Who was a pirate once, but who's out of his indentures today and who needs to lead a blameless life evermore.
But wait a bit. I object to pirates as sons-in-law.
We object to major generals as fathers-in-law.
Yes.
But we do not waive it. We do not press that point. We look over it. Oh,
what idea. And do you mean to tell me that you would deliberately rob me of these, the sole remaining props of my old age, and leave me to go through the remainder of my life unfriended, unprotected?
Hello.
Yes, that was the idea. Yeah. Tell me, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan?
Oh, damn!
Here we are again.
I ask you, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan?
Orphan?
Yes, orphan. Have you ever known what it is to be one?
I said orphan!
Orphan!
I think we're getting a bit confused here. I ask you, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan? And you say orphan. Now, as I understand you, you're merely repeating the word orphan to show that you understand me.
I didn't repeat the word orphan.
No, pardon me, you did.
I only repeated it once.
Ah, yes, but you did repeat it.
But not orphan!
Stop. I think I see where we're getting confused. Now, when you said orphan, did you mean orphan, a person who's lost his parents, or orphan frequently?
Ha!
These children whom you see are all that I can call my own.
Call them home.
Take them away from me, and I shall be indeed alone.
Orphelone.
If pity you can feel, leave me my soul, remaining joy. See, at your feet they kneel, your hearts you cannot steal, against the sad, sad tale of the lonely.
Although a dark career sometimes involves the not leave her.
Away, you grieve me.
Away, you grieve me.
I wish you'd leave me.
We wish you'd leave him. Domesticity, for the doctor of the
I will try, dear Bakewell. Why does he sit night after night in this drafty old ruin?
Why do I sit here? To escape the pirate's clutches, I describe myself as an orphan. Heaven help me, I am no orphan. I come here to humble myself before the tombs of my ancestors and to implore their pardon for having brought dishonor on the family escutcheon.
But you forget, sir, you only bought the property a year ago, and the plaster in your baronial hall is scarcely dry.
Frederick, in this chapel there are ancestors, you cannot deny that. With the estate, I bought the chapel and its contents. I don't know whose ancestors they were, but I know whose ancestors they aren't. And I shudder to think that their descendants by purchase, if I may so describe myself, should have brought dishonor on what I have no doubt was an unstained escutcheon.
Take comfort. Had you not acted as you did, these reckless men would have assuredly called in the nearest clergyman and married your large family on the spot.
So I thank you for your proffered solace, but it is unavailing. I assure you, Frederick, that such is the remorse I feel at the despicable falsehood by which I deceived these easily deluded pirates, that I'd go to their simple-minded chief this very night and confess all. And did I not fear that the consequences to myself would be most disastrous? At what time does your expedition march against these scoundrels?
At 11. And before 12, I hope to have atoned for my association with these pestilent scourges by sweeping them from the face of the earth. And then, dear Bakewell, you will be mine.
Are your devoted followers at hand?
They are. They only wait my orders.
Then, Frederick, let your escort, lion-hearted, be summoned to receive a general's blessing ere they depart upon their dread adventure.
Listen, they come.
Yeah. these adventures are well meant.
Very end.
Yes, well meant.
Very end.
Ah, yes, well meant.
Some singular coincidence, I shouldn't be surprised.
cried it was owing to the agency of an ill-natured fairy. You are the victim of this clumsy arrangement, having been born in leap year on the 29th of February. And so, by a simple arithmetical process, you will easily discover that while you've lived 21 years, yet, if we go by birthdays, you're only 5 and a little bit over.
E, let's see. Yes, yes, with yours my fingers do agree. How quaint the ways of paradox, at compensate she gaily mocks, yet reckoning in the usual way is 21 I've been alive, yet reckoning by my natal day. Yet reckoning by my natal day. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I am a little boy of five.
He is a little boy of five.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. A paradox.
I don't think you appreciate the delicacy of your position. You were apprenticed to us...
Until I reached my 21st year.
No. Until you reached your 21st birthday. And going by birthdays, you must get only 5 1/4.
You're not going to say you're going to hold me to that.
No, we merely remind us of you a fact. And leave the rest to your sense of duty.
Your sense of duty?
Oh, don't put it on that footing. As I was merciful to you just now, be merciful to me, I implore you, by not insisting on the letter of your bond, just as a cup of happiness is at my lips.
Well, we insist upon nothing. We content ourselves with reminding you of your duty.
Your duty?
Very well. You appeal to my sense of duty. My duty is only too clear. I adore your infamous calling, but duty is before all. At any cost, I will do my duty.
Well spoken, you are one of us once more.
Lead on, I follow. Oh, horror!
What's the matter?
Ought I to tell you? No, it would be right, and yet, as one of your band...
Speak out! I charge you by that sense of conscientiousness to which we have never yet appealed in vain.
General Stanley?
Yes?
The father of Mabel?
Yes.
He escaped from you on the appeal that he was an orphan.
He did. Oh, yes, he did.
Well, it breaks my heart to betray the honoured father of the girl I adore, but as your apprentice, I have no alternative. It is my duty to inform you that General Stanley is no orphan.
What?
More than that, he never was one.
Oh. Am I to understand that to save his contemptible life, he dared practice on our credulous simplicity? Our revenge shall be swift and terrible. We shall go and collect our band and attack to the Morden Castle this very night!
But stay!
Not a word! He is doomed! Away, away, my heart's on fire. I burn this beast descended to repay. This very night, my vent is there. Don't let yourself be torn away, away.
Away, away, ere I expire. My heart is filled with anguish dire. He strikes me to the core, away, away.
If all should foul be tempted on our night, then vengeance shall the trial of fate decide. Our crime to turn himself and with his life, and in return tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, tonight the traitor dies.
early tomorrow.
It tells the lies.
So a matter of sorrow.
The bots are smart.
And all the plot.
What music to bed.
Thank you.
return and claim me, why be collected?
It seems so long.
Swear that till then you will be true to me.
Yes, I'll be strong. Well, the Stanley's dead and gone, I sleep it.
Oh, here is love, and here is true, and here is true for joy and his love, that she will be faithful to us soon, till we are well and even after. Oh, here is love, and here is true. She will be faithful to herself.
She will be faithful to herself.
She'll be away, and even after.
She'll be away,
and even after.
Yes, even after.
Here is love, here is true. And here is love for joy and love. She will be faithful to herself.
She'll be away,
and
even after.
She will be faithful to herself. And then we'll be away, and even after.
Not a burglary.
And the
things to be done, to be done. And the next man's heart is not a happy one.
Must have been the Take my daughters, all of whom are beauties.